Let's construct a truth table for this statement here a couple of different ways. No matter which way we do this, we're going to have to enter P and Q in our first two columns. If we construct this truth table using the first method, then we're going to stick the entire statement in the final column of the truth table. Then we need to decide how we're going to build to this final statement. Well, the statement has a not P in it, so we're going to need a column that includes not P. We can also see that using order of operations, we're going to have to find P and Q. So we should have a column for P and Q. Finally, to fill out our last column, we will be comparing the not P column to the P and Q column using this OR. Okay, so let's actually go through it. Let's put all of the possible values for P and Q. Now let's fill out our column for not P. To get not P, we just reverse all of the truth values in our P column. Now to find P and Q, we might look back at the basic conjunction table that we created in the last video. The truth values in the P and Q column, we can see, are then going to be true, false, false, and false. Now to fill out our final column, what we need to do is we need to compare our not P values to our P and Q values using this disjunction, because that's what this operation is telling us to do. So we might look back at our rules for disjunctions, and disjunctions are only false if the two things that we're comparing are both false. So since we're comparing this column with this column, if we have a false and a true, our disjunction should be true. If we have a false and a false, our disjunction should be false. If we have a true and a false, we should have a true, and if we have a true and a false, we should have a true. So our answer column for this truth table gives us these results. Now let's construct the same truth table using a slightly different method. As always, we'll just start with our P and Q column, but this time let's just put our entire statement in the last column and spread it out a bit. Now under not P, we're just going to reverse the truth values on P, just like before. Then I'm going to copy our P and Q values down over here. Then just like doing order of operations, we'll complete this AND statement first because it's in parentheses. In between the P and the Q, we'll put our answers for this conjunction. From the work that we did in the last video, we know that these conjunction answers are going to be true, false, false, and false. And now to get our answer column, what we can do is we can compare this column here with this column here. We're comparing these two columns with an or a disjunction, because that's the symbol right here. And we know from our disjunction rules that all of our answers should be true unless both truth values that we're comparing are false. So we have a false and a true that we're comparing. That's going to give us true. We have a false and a false. That for our disjunction is going to give us a false. We have a true and a false, and we have a true and a false. Our answer column ends up right here in the middle, and you can see that these two answer columns are the same. So whatever method you like best, go ahead and use. I'll do one more example using each method. For our next example, let's construct a truth table for this statement. As always, we'll just start with columns for P and Q. Then let's use the first method. We're going to build up to this final statement here. So I'll put this final statement in the final column. You'll notice that this final statement has a not P in it, so I think we can put a not P over here. This statement then has a not P or Q, so I'll put that statement here in this column, and then we're going to compare not P or Q to P with the conditional. So this is a personal preference, but I'm going to copy my P column down here so I can more easily figure out this final column. Okay, let's start filling this thing out. We start with all possibilities for P and Q. If we want to fill out our not P column, we can just reverse the truth values in P. Our next column involves a disjunction, so we might look at our old disjunction table. We're comparing not P to Q, and using our rules for disjunction or, we get true in this column unless both of the values we're comparing are false. Next, I'm just going to copy my P column down one more time. Now, for our final answer, this statement says that we need to compare this statement with this statement using a conditional. So we're going to be comparing this column with a conditional. So let's go back and grab our old conditional table from the previous video. If you want to see where these tables are coming from, I'll make sure that a link is popping up to the previous video right now. But what we learned from this conditional table in the last video is that we only get false if our first truth value is true and our second truth value is false. So we're comparing these two columns over here. If we have a true and a true, we can see from our conditional table that we should get an answer of true. If we have a false and a true, we can see from our conditional table that we should also get a true. If we have a true and a false, we can see from our conditional table that we should get a false. And again, if we have true and a false, we should get false. So our answer column in this case looks like this. Let's do one more example using the second technique. And using this technique, we start with our P in our Q column, and then in our final column, we just kind of spread out our final statement. So let's fill out our P's and our Q's. Okay, then we need to use order of operations here. The innermost set of parentheses tells us that we need to compare P and Q with an OR. So we can copy our P's down here if we'd like. Then we're comparing P and Q with this OR, so we can bring up that disjunction table. In our first row, we have a true and a true, so our disjunction is true. And the second row, we have a true and a false, so we get a true. And our third row, we have a false and a true, so we get true. In our final row, we have a false and a false, so we get a false. Now, it's not totally necessary that you copied all of these P's and these Q's down a second time, because you could read them from this part of the table over here. So it's only essential that you have this column here written in your table. Now, according to our order of operations, we're going to take this column and we're going to compare that with not Q using a conjunction. So we could start by filling out our not Q column. It's going to be a false, a true, a false, and a true. To get not Q, I just reversed all the truth values in Q. Now we're going to compare these values with these values using a conjunction. So let's bring up our conjunction table. And we learned that the results of our conjunction are only true if both values that we're comparing are true. So let's go up here and take a look. We have a true and a false we're comparing. That gives us a false. We have a true and a true. That gives us true. We have a true and a false. That gives us false. And we have a false and a true. That gives us false. Now, finally, we're going to compare this column with our P column, which I can just copy down. So we're comparing these two columns using a conditional. Let's bring back our conditional table. The rules from the conditional table that we learned is that we only get a false value if the first value we're comparing is true and the second is false. So let's take a look. We're comparing a false and a true. So down in our conditional table, that would give us a true. Next, we're comparing a true and a true in our conditional table. That would give us true. Next, we have a false and a false, and in our conditional table, that gives us true. And last, we have another false and false, which again gives us true. Now, this is our answer column. We see that we get all trues. So this has a name. Anytime we get all true as our answer column in a truth table, we call that a tautology. And if this tautology happens to be a conditional, we call this an implication. Basically, what we're saying is no matter what, this original statement up here is always going to be a true statement. For one last additional piece of vocabulary, if we happen to get all false in our answer column of our truth table, we would call that a self-contradiction. That means that whatever the statement we were working with, it is never going to be true. Okay, so I think that's going to do it for that video. Hopefully a couple of examples will help you out. We'll do a lot more in class. I'll see you there.